It's time for your daily crypto update with Framework Fortune Crypto. I'm your host, Ben. Now let's dive in. Bitcoin, having some trouble here. Struggling with that downtrend. I don't like that it pulled back below this downtrend. We really need to see a break there. But it is still holding above the 10-day moving average on the daily chart. So it is still bullish. Looking at it on the 4-hour, you can see we are currently testing the downtrend. So if it can break over that, get back over 49 and actually hold, this candle didn't hold. There was too much selling pressure, pushed it back under that trend. We need to see the next candle up hold that 49 area. And then once that holds as support, we can see Bitcoin test 50,000. I thought we were going to test 50,000 again by this time, but there's a lot of selling pressure, so it is taking a while. It does at the moment look like an inverse head and shoulders. This would be one shoulder head here and then another shoulder here. So this breakout could be a big breakout where it blows right through 50,000. That is a possibility. If we get held up at this trend line though, this downtrend, then we're going to see a bearish move on Bitcoin and probably see it back down to 46,000 to test this previous support. So right now it's looking good. But we'll see if the momentum continues or not. Kind of low volume right now while I'm recording this. Ethereum does look like a head and shoulders. There's a shoulder, head, shoulder. And it did have an arm down, but it did not continue down. So this little rebound pushing back up to 3250 is actually a nice little sign of strength. I do think we are going to see that test of 3300. And probably a test of 3,500 soon on Ethereum. It's been consolidating nicely and seems the price is getting tighter and tighter. We're kind of getting squeezed here. So there's going to be a pop one way or the other. So Cardano just riding right up that 10-day. That's perfectly fine to me as long as it continues and breaks through $3. Should be good to go. We just had a pretty good pullback and then another little breather here. All we need to see is buying volume start ramping up again like we had here. And we could easily see this over $3. It's held up really well, so I think it's going to break $3 here soon. Cosmos with that perfect inverse head and shoulders breakout. Shoulder, head, shoulder. But it's the inverse. It's the opposite. But getting a nice break over 2050 and running all the way up to 2240. Very bullish move. Looks like to me Cosmos is going to continue to move on up. There's a lot going on with this ecosystem right now. There's a lot of hype building up behind a lot of the projects. So I'm still fully expecting Cosmos to get to 25, maybe even higher. So we got a couple of gainers today popping up. We got ICP just broke out, ran from 63 to 73 in the past 10 hours. Very nice move. They could break this level at 75, then it could get back up to some of those previous highs in the $100 area, but does have some tough resistance across 75 as of now. The EMAs are all where they need to be though, looking pretty bullish. And then we got Scale Network breaking up out of that triangle, pushing over 40 cents, pushed up to 43, and so far it's confirming and holding the 40 cent resistance line that is now acting as support. That confirms Scale is going to keep climbing. We'll probably see it up to 50 cents. Very nice move so far out of there. Now, if for some reason it starts cracking back below this 38 cent area, then this could be a fake out breakout. So that's why this candle here has to confirm and stay above 40 cents. And then StormX get another pop up back over that 3 cent area. It's been testing it. This is a little double bottom here. Looks like it's going to give it another test. And you see the volume is really starting to increase on StormX. Light volume through this whole rip until now. So if this big volume continues, we could see StormX continue to move on up. So Mana, this one I was talking about as a swing. I got in here at 90 cents. And it's pushed up to a dollar. So I'm up some profit so far. But I think, it, like I said, with those updates coming to the game, I think we could see it break out and move higher. So I'm still holding as of now. Luna breaking out even more, pushed all the way to 37, making another new high. So far, it's trying to hold the 10-day and this previous resistance at that 34 area, but is below it. So we could see a pullback to 31.50, and then if that doesn't hold, it would be down to 30.50 at the 50-day. Preferably, we want to see it hold this 33.50 area, or this 34 area, and curl back around and up if it's going to continue to rip. Mirror Protocol still being sneaky, popped up that 450 but pulled back again. Still bullish with the 10-day over all the other EMAs, and it does look like it's trying to hold support at 425. So if it can bounce off that 425, we'll see it continue to climb the $5. This is being a really slow mover, but it's a very low supply coin, so I'm keeping a very close eye on it. It just needs to move. Solana holding over 90. Very strong move to try to hold this support and hold this 10-day moving average in this 90 area. Rebreak of 95, and we're going to see Solana up to $100 testing. It has had some very strong, consistent buying volume, and if that pushes back in, we could see Solana over $100. This has been a nice rip so far, but the fact it's holding up right now, that's a pretty strong sign. It could crack though at any minute, and if it does, it would fall all the way back down to $80. So you do got to be aware that there is a big drop below you if you got in way up here at the top waiting for this consolidation. I'd like to see Solana hold above 95 by the end of tonight if it doesn't break out. If it starts testing 90 as support, then I'd be really concerned. So my prediction on Tezos up to $10 might not have been as bold as I thought it was. After I recorded that video yesterday and put it out, Tezos has ran up to 6, currently testing 6, but giving it a good test. It hasn't dropped off yet. The 10-day is still down here and it's staying above there. It looks like it may try to make a little bit of a flag here on the 4-hour chart. So if it ends up breaking that flag, it could continue on up. Shiba not looking so hot. This was definitely a head and shoulders pattern. You can see the shoulder there, head there, the other shoulder, and then the big arm down, the sell off. So it's trying to start building back up, but the 50 did cross over the 200 there. So that's a pretty bearish sign. Let's look at it on the daily chart, see if it's bearish there too. Yeah, so close to going bearish on the daily chart. Basically, if it drops below this line right here, 50680, then this would be a bearish move. And we could actually see Shiba start to sell off some more. It's been holding in this channel of consolidation. We can see it down to that bottom, but if it breaks the bottom of this channel, and then it could drop quite a bit. If you're a Shiba player, you may want to keep a close eye on this channel. That's all the coins I'm going to cover for today. This has not been as active as a weekend as I thought it was going to be for cryptos. I mean, we still are seeing some pops across the altcoins, but Bitcoin and Ethereum haven't really made any crazy moves. Just consolidations right under that resistance. And they haven't really tested that much either. So I really was expecting to see them test this weekend, which does make me a little concerned. But we'll see with the stock market being real choppy now. And it seems like there's a lot of money moving into cryptos from the stock market and other asset classes. If that continues, we could see these big breakouts continue as well. But if the stock market all of a sudden gets hot, then we might see money leave from the crypto market and go back to the stock market, which could cause some drops, so maybe even unexpected drops in the crypto market this week. So hard to say. I'm still pretty bullish. I think we're going to keep testing because we're still having altcoins break out. And tonight, if we see another altcoin make a pretty decent size move, then I think we'll see the bullish crypto market continue. So if there's any coins that I'm not currently covering that you'd like me to cover, leave them in the comments below. and let me know your thoughts on which way you think the crypto market is going. Appreciate everybody joining me as always. Stay safe out there. Until next time.